Welcome to the World Challenge 2008. Coming up in this programme, Plan B, a sweet solution to providing an income for women in rugged northern Pakistan. And nothing is impossible for the Nairobi slum dwellers being helped by the Hawkers Market Centre. But first, a reminder of the website where you can vote for your favourite World Challenge 2008 finalist, theworldchallenge.co.uk. World Challenge 2008 features 12 enterprising businesses and projects from around the world. It's for you to choose which one you think is the most deserving of the World Challenge Cash Awards. Northern Pakistan, while bees the world over have been dying off from disease and environmental stress, the bees here are thriving. They yield a delicious honey. The women who collect it believe it to be gold standard, simply the best. One problem. While being far away from the environmental conditions that stress the bees, they're also far away from the markets that will pay top dollar for their top quality product. This is Gilgit. It was once a thriving trading centre on the ancient Silk Route. Today it's not on any main route, and tourism has slumped with the country's political instability. Getting products out of here adds to costs. As a result, most of what is produced here is eaten here. That's called subsistence farming, and subsistence means poverty, especially for the women whose status is many notches below the men in this conservative society. Enter the Hashoo Foundation, a non-profit organisation set up by the Hashwani family. Chair Sarah Hashwani wants to see some changes in these remote communities. To make this happen, the foundation began giving training in beekeeping. Crucially, the Hashoo Foundation was also able to link these remote honey producers to lucrative markets in Pakistan's five-star hotels.
We're not interested in just helping them earn more money, but we want to see that their children are better educated, that their children have access to health care, that they have better sanitation in the house, they have access to better nutrition. It's been close to a year that we started the project. We've seen a tremendous difference in the lives of the women and the families.
Oh, honey, honey. 80 women and 5 men form the Gilgit Bee Association. Each has received training from the association, which has also provided each member with one beehive to kickstart their business. The Aga Khan Rural Support Programme offered training and incentives for the association members.
Honeybee was not a tradition in this area, but we saw opportunity for this particular sector, and we provided basic training, did basic research, and provided small amounts of credit, and developed this sector from the supply side. And we found Hashoo Foundation to be a very good partner to work from the market side. So they brought expertise in terms of packaging, in terms of linking them with the market. They took up from there and developed this further. And we helped them in creating an association of honey producers, and it worked very well. And now there is a very large number of women involved in this income generating activity, and it has worked very well.
The abundance of wild plants and the relative lack of chemical contamination has created a perfect environment for honey production. The nectar of choice for these mountain bees comes from the blossom of the hardy Russian olive and robinia trees, which produce the distinctive taste of mountain honey.
Honey has brought a great atmosphere to our home and has increased the money coming in. With this, I have been able to educate my 5 children more effectively, especially as they are now in high school.
Mayor has been producing honey since 2001 and is vice president of the Gilgit Honey Bee Association. Her husband was apprehensive to begin with about her work, but has now changed his mind completely. In fact, he's now left his own job as a stonemason to join her. They own 19 hives and earn about $2,000 a year.
I don't follow the advice of anyone else apart from what we as a family discuss at home. If I had followed the advice of my friends, things would have been different. We have to go further with our enterprise and become more successful.
It's made a big difference. When he was working as a stonemason, I used to waste a lot of time running after him, taking him tea and food. We were never happy. We used to be dependent on people, and they make us feel as if we are begging. It was frustrating. For a long time, I was thinking how I could be independent, and finally, I decided on this project. Now we are not dependent on anybody, and we are not worried about job security. This project has given us our autonomy, and this has improved our relationships at home and reduced tension.
Welcome to my home. Do come inside.
Zar Bano has been in the bee business for 8 years, and her honey has earned her several awards.
My work has been recognised by many organisations. This is my most recent award for my honey, of which I'm very proud. I got it in December. I've other certificates too.
Last year, her bumper crop earned her 50,000 rupees, or $800. This year, she has set a bigger target, to earn $1,000. She's proud, not just of her awards, but of what the extra cash has meant for her family. A newcomer to bees, Shamim Jafar, has been a hive owner for just 1 year, but already she's seeing the benefits. She used to be totally reliant on her husband's income, but his policeman's salary was not enough to educate their 6 children.
Since we've been involved with this organisation, it has brought us a lot of benefits. Previously, we used to have to go from door to door trying to sell our honey ourselves. Now they buy it from us in bulk and they pay us straight away, even if it's just 1 rupee, and this has made a huge improvement to our income.
It's hard work too. During the year, the hives are moved from valley to valley to follow the course of the flowering season. The bee producers bring their honey to this central depot, where the Association of Mountain Organic Honey Traders pays them directly. Already this year, their rate has gone up from 250 to 270 rupees per kilo. Here, some of the honey is packaged into gift boxes, bound for diplomatic missions in Islamabad, the capital city. The bulk is bought by a chain of 5-star hotels associated with the Hashoo Foundation. Some is eaten in the hotels, but most is sold to the guests in the attractive packaging at international rates, about $7 a jar.
Very nice honey. It had a distinct flavour to it. Good texture too. I liked it very much.
Very good. Very good.
We have other honeys available in Pakistan and Punjab areas, but this honey I prefer the best.
I think this packaging is much, much prettier than the last one. So congratulations.
Yeah.
This is really a lot of hard work has gone into it.
The added value of quality control, high quality packaging and marketing means a real boost to earnings.
In Gilgit, in their local market, they cannot sell it. They don't have access to market outside. So we are here to provide them to have a big market beyond the mountains of northern areas.
If the foundation won a World Challenge prize, it would use the funds to strengthen the brand and find new markets outside Pakistan for the beekeepers of Gilgit.
As a foundation, we need to concentrate on developing a strong brand, which we can take to the international markets. We are working on our fair trade certification, we are working on our international organic certification. But once we have these certifications in place, we will be able to then look aggressively to the international markets. I think that is the role that we would like to play.
Remember, you have the chance to decide which World Challenge 2008 finalist is the most deserving. Your vote can help them win a cash prize. Visit theworldchallenge.co.uk and find out how you can cast your vote. Don't go away. In part two of World Challenge 2008, the slum dwellers of Nairobi who are getting the chance of an education.